early morning of one of the brightest days in Washington's history brings people by the train load, the bus load, the plane load from every part of America to their capital. The widely heralded and in some quarters feared March on Washington is expected to draw 100,000 people here in peaceful demonstration for equal rights and employment for Negroes. Instead, twice that many, including 30,000 white people, converge on the Washington Monument where the activities are to begin. The bus caravans from the Deep South, the West, and the North reach their destinations on Constitution and Independence Avenues and let off their passengers for their one, for many, their only day here in the beautiful parkland south of the White House. The mood of the vast crowd is relaxed, friendly, and dignified, but above all, it is determined. Though there is much of the feeling of a church picnic, and indeed the singing of gospel hymns is everywhere, this is no picnic. It is one step in a struggle for equality under law that began with the signing of the Emancipation Proclamation a century ago, and has been rapidly accelerating in the past 3.5 years. Washington has seen far larger crowds and gaudier celebrations than this, but these have been spectator crowds. Never have so many people participated in an event in the Capitol, and with such a feeling of hope and friendship. There have been other marches on Washington, too, but none with so little bitterness, so little aggressiveness, or hint of coerciveness. Randolph, president of the Brotherhood of Sleeping Car Porters, Roy Wilkins, executive secretary of the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, Walter Reuther of the AFL-CIO, and the Reverend Martin Luther King, head the march down Constitution Avenue to the Lincoln Memorial. A parallel group proceeds down Independence Avenue to the south.
And one day on the red hills of Georgia, sons of former slaves and the sons of former slavers, will they be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood? I have a dream.